Yes, it's now Little Arrow's story time. Our book is The Biggest Bear, illustrated by Adam Relf. Little Arrow's story time begins now. One night, Toby was bouncing up and down on his bed. He could see a shadow on the wall. It looked like a great big bear jumping up and down next to him. "I bet that's the biggest bear in the world," he said. The next morning, Toby asked his daddy if the shadow bear was the biggest bear in the world.
"Oh no," said Daddy. "There's a much bigger bear than that."
"Can we go see him?" asked Toby.
"You'll have to wait until later," said Daddy.
Along the way, Toby saw a great big chocolate bear in a store window. "Is that the biggest bear in the world?" he asked.
"Oh, no," said Daddy. "There's a much bigger bear than that."
"When can we see him?" asked Toby.
"Later. A little later. First you have to go to preschool," said Daddy.
At preschool, Toby painted a picture. He wanted to paint a really big bear, but the paper was too small.
"It's still a very nice bear," said Daddy when he picked Toby up. "And you'll see the biggest bear in the world later on. But for now, let's go to the park."
"Okay." At the park, Toby saw a huge bear made of stone. It was a fountain, and water poured out of its mouth. "Is that the biggest bear in the world?" Toby asked.
"Oh, no. Oh, no," said Daddy. "The biggest bear is much bigger than that."
"Really? Well, will we see him soon?" asked Toby.
"Pretty soon," said Daddy. "Let's go get ice cream."
"Okay." On the other side of the park, they found a carnival.
"There he is! I see him!" shouted Toby. "That must be the biggest bear."
"Oh, no," laughed Daddy. "He's big, but the biggest bear in the world is much bigger."
Toby shook paws with the big bear, and they walked on. On the way home, Toby and his daddy stopped to look at an enormous balloon bear floating above the town.
"There can't be a bigger bear than that," said Toby, but Daddy just grinned.
Back at home, Daddy gave Toby his dinner.
"Is there really a bigger bear than the balloon bear?" asked Toby.
"Yes," said Daddy. "A much, much bigger one."
"But where does he live if he's so big?" asked Toby.
"I'll give you a clue," said Daddy. "He lives above our heads. Can you guess where?"
Is he in the attic?" asked Toby.
"Is he on the roof?"
But Daddy just shook his head.
At last, it was bedtime, and Toby still hadn't guessed where the biggest bear lived.
"I don't believe there is a biggest bear," he said sadly, and he trudged upstairs to bed.
A moment later, Daddy came into Toby's room.
"Don't be sad, Toby," he said. "You couldn't see the biggest bear during the day because he only comes out at night. Would you like to see him now?"
"Is he scary?"
"No," said Daddy. He's not scary at all.
Daddy led Toby down the stairs and out into the garden.
Look up at the sky, he said. Do you see those bright stars?
Toby gazed up into the darkness.
That group of stars is called the Great Bear, Daddy said. Can you see his tail? And his paws?
Oh! Said Toby. He was right above our heads all the time. That really is the biggest bear in the whole world. Thanks, Daddy.
You're welcome, Toby.
The end. Good night.
If you enjoyed this story, please click the like and subscribe button. And don't forget to hit the notification bell and be in the know for new episodes of Little Arrow Storytime. This is Sophia Robinson, and until next time, happy listening.